Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined now by Nick De Blocq, who is the CEO of Kinetiko Energy. Nick, it's great to have you back on, and it's been a couple of months since we last had an update from you. So how have you been spending the time?
It's good to be back and chatting with you, Thomas. Look, mate, we've been busy. At the end of last year, we did a few things that became important milestones in our journey. You know, first was the merger of Podimo into Kinetiko on the AGM. During the AGM on the 30th of November, we had not a single dissenting vote. It was 100% in support, and therefore, administratively, we consider that closed. There are, you know, there's some financing issues remaining in order to completely close it, to do with the merging of the shareholdership into the new company. But there are solutions becoming evident as we speak. We also drilled, I think at the time we last spoke, we were busy with our second of a 7 core hole campaign. We had just drilled one outside of the Majuba power station, and we were busy with our first exploratory hole, borehole in block ER270 in the proximity of Newcastle, the industrial hub of the Midlands of the KwaZulu-Natal province. So since then, we've been able to announce the results of the initial borehole and the first borehole in 270. The Majuba borehole, as we call it, or 23C, 271-23C, we broke records, Thomas. It was so exciting. We got over 131 meters of gas cut in the profile of the borehole, and the desorption analysis that we've done since then. For scale and reference, I can tell you for a good producible core, a good producible borehole, you'll be getting around 4 or 5 cubes per ton. That's the units that's measured in the desorption. We're at 13 and climbing. I mean, it's absolutely eye-watering. It's fantastic, the result of that borehole, you know, which obviously leads us to believe we can probably become a substantial supplier into Majuba Power Station, which is designed to be co-fired with gas, you know, so it's almost a no-brainer. Moving into ER270, our first exploratory core hole in that block, goodness sake, we cut 147 meters of gassy pay in those sands, you know. So we're kind of breaking record after record as we hit these various milestones. It's very exciting. We're in as I said, the proximity of both the Lily pipeline and the city of Newcastle, where ArcelorMittal is the major thermal industry, but there are many others in that area. Naturally, feeding into the Lily pipeline means we can help Sasol's existing customers down in Richards Bay and Durban on the coastline of KwaZulu-Natal, because they're going to be facing a bit of a depletion of their gas, given that the onshore fields in Mozambique have been producing for more than a quarter of a century. It's a long lifespan. They are bound to deplete reasonably soon. And, Sasol will be using a lot more of its own gas to make liquid fuels from. They have a stated intent to move away from coal to liquids, at which they are the world champion, into a more gas to liquids industry. So, you know, the prospect of markets for our gas just keeps bubbling up. It's wonderful.
Understood. So you've got seemingly enormous quantities of gas there. The demand is in place. So how are we going to get to the point where you're starting to meet that demand? What's the timeline looking like?
That is literally the million-dollar question. We have to evolve our exploration rights, Thomas, into production rights. You know, so this is something we've started. This is something that we will be evolving and completing within this year, and hopefully months, you know, rather than much longer than that. One has to start a production right application with getting the facts right. So, you know, the coordinates of all the farmlands in the areas under rights, the updated landowner list, etc. We have to meet with local communities, you know, the engagement with the communities where we work. Obviously, we have to get environmental scoping documents done, etc., etc. So there's a lot of groundwork to do by the time that we submit. Now, we have been fortunate in getting our project registered with the Presidential Infrastructural Commission under a body called the SIP, Strategic Infrastructure Projects. And this body claims to have expediting powers. So, in other words, the president's office reaching down into government departments and saying, you know, come along, never mind a year doing that. We want it by Friday, if you understand, you know, with a bit of an exaggeration. But we do believe that this body will help us to chivvy it along. And perhaps within, I'm going to thumbsuck about a half a year from now, if I'm optimistic, Thomas, you know, we could literally be producing molecules commercially. So, you know, I'm not going to put my hand on the Bible and say that it will be 6 months, but I should certainly think, you know, between 6 and 12, we should have a production right. We will have a gen set in the field. We should be doing our proof of concept gas to power, just four wells producing a single megawatt, you know, and build it up from there and stage it up from there. Further to the south, the southern side of Block 271, north of 270, where we have the deeper sediments, the Karoo Basin slopes southwards. So that's why we're getting more and more gas cut the further south we go. You know, we're in very advanced discussions now with at least two players in the midstream LNG game that will be bringing infrastructure of the cryogenic boxes that we need to make LNG for virtual pipeline to thermal industries and GTP requirements. You know, so it's all getting very real and it's getting very exciting.
It's a fascinating project. I feel like I could ask you questions about it all day, Nick, but we are going to leave it there. So thank you very much for joining me today on Proactive.
Thank you, Thomas, indeed. I look forward to chatting again. We're drilling a lot of holes right now. I've got 24 to do this year, so you and I will be chatting a lot. Thank you.
Fantastic.